Big mirror now impact. Maharashtra releases final RERA rules, comes a step closer to getting a regulator. Meanwhile, in Karnataka, additional chief secretary's transfer sparks outrage, but the housing minister says it was a routine transfer. India's drug regulator declares popular medicines like Combiflam and Decold as substandard. This after a series of quality tests conducted last month. Drugs made by big names like Sanofi India, Reckitt Benckiser, Cipla and Cadila allegedly failed quality tests.
ये 500 बोल रहे कारपेट है बिल्डर पे आज तक किसी ने हमें लिख के नहीं दिया महाड़ा ने तो ऑफिशियल लिख के नहीं दिया है
आज हम जो सदियों से हमारा रखड़ा हुआ डेवलपमेंट है आज इस सरकार ने पूरा किया हमें स्वागत है अच्छा है हमें बट हमें विश्वास भी लिया जाए ये लोकशाही है हुकुमशाही नहीं है
महाराष्ट्र चीफ मिनिस्टर इनॉग्रेट्स एन एंबिशियस स्कीम टू रीडेवलप सेंट्रल मुंबईज ओल्डेस्ट चौल्स मीनवाइल पुलिस अरेस्ट 12 पीपल हु प्रोटेस्टेड अगेंस्ट द गवर्नमेंट्स न्यू स्कीम
उनका कचरा पुणे मनपा का कचरा पुणे मनपा में डालो और ये गांव गांव में एक भी गाड़ी का कचरा डाल के देंगे ना ये लोग
And in Pune, villagers of Urli are agitating against the Pune Municipal Corporation dumping more garbage in the Urli Devachi dump yard.
We are standing at your feet. Please save the government doctors. It is not our privilege, it is our right. Please save.
Tamil Nadu health system, which is one of the best in the nation, will collapse.
Outpatient services hit in Chennai as hospitals, as doctors are still on mass leave. Protest High Court's decision to scrap the quota in postgraduate seats for doctors on rural posting. Hello and welcome to the news on Mirror Now. I'm Kavita Krishnan. Starting with a big Mirror Now impact, after this channel raised concerns about the builder-friendly RERA rules, the State Housing Department took note and released consumer-friendly final rules on Friday. The Maharashtra regulator will come into force on the 1st of May 2017. Amita Balachandra gets us more details.
Huge win for home buyers indeed. The state of Maharashtra has gone ahead and published final RERA rules after Mirror Now's coverage on Real Estate Regulatory Act draft rules, of course, which were builder friendly. Now these rules are consumer friendly. A couple of points that come through, of course. One, money lenders have been defined under the Money Lenders Act. Carpet area can be recalculated on possession with the variation cap, and builders cannot discriminate home buyers based on caste, religion or eating habits. All of these have come through after Mirror Now did a special show on making these rules more consumer friendly. Now, of course, we understand that a regulator will be set up by the 1st of May, and we're hearing from the Housing Minister Prakash Mehta himself that Gautam Chatterjee could be the housing regulator. Additionally, once these rules come in, it's good news for the real estate sector because it's going to bring in more transparency into the sector and ensure home buyers' rights are safeguarded. Amita Balachandra for Mirror Now.
We also got in touch with the Housing Minister of Maharashtra, Prakash Mehta, who confirmed the release of the final rules for the regulator. He also confirmed that retired bureaucrat Gautam Chatterjee is likely to become the first chairman of the state's housing regulator. Listen in.
अभी हमें पता चला है कि रूल्स बाहर निकला है तो हमें पता चल रहा है कि गौतम चैटर्जी हाउसिंग रेगुलेटर बनेंगे क्या कहना चाहते हैं
तो पहले ही डिक्लेयर कर दिया है वो तो ऑफिशियली उनकी नियुक्ति भी हो चुकी है
फाइनल रेगुलेटर तो ये मई 1st तक सब कुछ
बिल्कुल तैयार है मई 1 तारीख से आपको अगर
और आपकी मैसेज क्या है होम बायर्स के लिए क्योंकि अभी तक बहुत सारी प्रोजेक्ट डिलेज वगैरह होते रहे
जो भी रनिंग प्रोजेक्ट है जो भी उसमें बायर होंगे उनकी कोई भी अड़चन होगी अभी के कानून में सब प्रावधान है उसका आधार लेकर वो 1 तारीख से अपनी जो भी तकरार है वो दर्ज करा सकते हैं उसको न्याय मिलेगा
Meanwhile, in Bengaluru, days ahead of the implementation of RERA in Karnataka, Rajiv Chawla, the additional chief secretary to the housing department, has been transferred. Now, many activists from the NGO Fight for RERA have objected to the transfer. Activists allege that the secretary was transferred under pressure from government officials who were looking to dilute the RERA bill. However, when Mirror Now spoke to M. Krishnappa, Housing Minister of Karnataka, he refuted all allegations and he said that the transfer of Rajiv Chawla was routine. Listen in to Srija.
Just days ahead of the implementation of RERA in Karnataka, Rajiv Chawla, the additional secretary to Housing Department, was transferred by the state government. However, talking to M. Krishnappa, the housing minister, he told Mirror Now that this was just a routine transfer. However, the activists from the Fight for RERA organization have taken a serious objection to this transfer just a few days before the implementation of RERA, which is set to take place on May 1st. Another thing needs to be noted is that when RERA is implemented, this definitely brings in transparency, also delivery of projects on time to the buyers. Another thing is the clearance of the project. Any builder who has more than 8 apartments will have to register with the regulator and take the occupancy certificate. However, from activists, Mirror Now learns that there was a lot of pressure on Rajiv Chawla, the additional secretary, to dilute the RERA, where ongoing projects was not required to be included in the RERA Act. In fact, this definitely is a cause of concern here for the state. However, when we spoke to the housing minister, he cleared the air by saying that there is no pressure as such and they are planning to implement RERA on May 1st. And he, in fact, refuted all the allegations on the top officials where, in fact, the activists accused the officials of transferring Rajiv Chawla only because they wanted to dilute RERA. Another thing needs to be important is noted here is that RERA definitely brings in transparency, but as far as the act is concerned, diluting the act is definitely a major cause of concern for the state. In Bengaluru, Srija from Mirror Now.
See, we are terribly shocked with this news. So we were under the impression that the Karnataka state will come out with their rules by 30th April, which is the deadline for any states, because all the sections of, RERA Act has been notified by Ministry of HUPO on 19th April, which has given the deadline as a 30th April. So at this stage, even he has given a press notice, the interview to a media, stating that the government don't have any choices to dilute the RERA, and they have to notify the RERA rules before the 30th April. Maybe this made the people who are working behind this dilution of RERA rules, especially for the ongoing project, showed the way for him to go out of these departments. In the same press note, there has been a mention stating that few government officials also opined that they are getting a lot of pressure from other government officials to dilute the RERA, like something like Uttar Pradesh.
And a story coming out of Mumbai, a 28-year-old who was allegedly molested by two men on a bike was served quick justice, as Mumbai police were able to nab the two accused within 36 hours of the crime. The senior executive of a reputed company in Mumbai was allegedly groped and molested right outside her residence gate in Sakinaka, Andheri. Right after the incident, the victim tweeted her ordeal to the Mumbai police, who used CCTV footage to nab the accused. Listen in to more details from my colleague Richa Sharma.
That's right, in yet another shocking incident of crime and molestation against a woman, a 28-year-old senior executive of a financial company was groped and molested right outside her residential complex while she was waiting for a taxi to arrive by a group of two teenagers who were actually traveling and zooming past her on a bike. And while she was standing on the road, she was groped by one of the main accused, 19-year-old Akshay Gupta, who molested her and just zoomed past by. And she tried to chase behind them till about 50 meters. Then she gave up, after which she tweeted to the Mumbai police, and immediately she got a reaction back. And she also gathered a lot of CCTV evidence in this whole case, which helped the police to actually arrest and capture these main two accused, one of which who's a minor. And according to police sources, Akshay Gupta was arrested within 36 hours of the CCTV footage which was produced in front of the police. And so far, they are trying to investigate into this matter if this main accused has conducted or has performed such cases of molestation in past as well or not. And according to police sources, they have stated that the main accused, 19-year-old, is a drug addict, and he is currently in police custody after he was produced in front of the Andheri court, and sections 34 as well as 354 of the IPC have been launched against him. This is Richa Sharma for Mirror Now, Mumbai.
This happened at around, say, 8:10. I was going for work. I was waiting for my cab and standing right across the road, like right across my building. And I just kept the phone and I started looking at my emails when, within a minute, I felt a huge thrust at a very inappropriate place. And when I looked up, I just saw a smiling face, like a smirking face. And I lost my head. I started running and shouting. I shouted really loud. So I was looking for autos and stuff so that, you know, I could get in an auto and probably chase him. But by that time, I had lost track of him. I immediately texted my friend who lives in the same building, and I told him that, you know, I have to do something about it. And he said that, okay, let's find some evidence. And he immediately went to the control room. At around 3 o'clock, I got out of my work, went to the police station with her and one of my other friends. And we filed the FIR and we gave them the footages, and the police was very cooperative. The next day at around, say, 3 o'clock, and the guy was caught by 9 o'clock. Like within 5-6 hours, they had caught him.
When I saw the message on the group, I immediately contacted the gentleman who had forwarded the message, and I told him, you know, just ask the lady to contact me or give my number, and I'll be there with her at the police station, you know. And the gentleman was very prompt, and I'm sure the lady must have been really tensed. And say by about 3 o'clock, when she contacted me, when she narrated the whole thing to me, I was taken aback. I must say that Sakinaka jurisdiction, under the leadership of Mr. Dharmadhikari, everything, the entire the interrogation or whatever has happened, has gone up very well.
On to Delhi polls now. The city is gearing up to vote for the Delhi they want on Sunday. Campaigning, of course, ended officially on Friday, and Delhiites spent their Saturday mulling over their final choice. Let's now go across to our correspondent Milan Sharma, who spoke with resident welfare associations in East Delhi area, who told her about the issues that will be the deciding factor on which they will cast their vote on Sunday.
The campaigning may have stopped by multiple political parties. Tomorrow on the 23rd, the Delhi is going to see the MCD elections. I'm in the wards of Krishna Nagar in East Delhi, talking to the residents of the area about issues that they are going to cast their vote for. Ravi, please tell us about the issues that this area or constituency faces every day.
Basically, yahan jo hai bahut zyada gandagi, सैनिटेशन के लेके ड्रेनेज की प्रॉब्लम है, पार्किंग की प्रॉब्लम है, एनक्रोचमेंट, हर चीज़ की प्रॉब्लम है, कोई काम नहीं होता. वो क्या कहते हैं, सड़क पे गड्ढे हैं, इतना ख़राब है सबको, वाटर लॉगिंग हो जाता है जब बारिश आती है, क्योंकि ड्रेनेज नहीं है प्रॉपर. सैनिटेशन नहीं होगा तो क्या होगा, इसी से होगा सारे मच्छर, जो होगी चिकनगुनिया, डेंगू, सब उसी से होता है. इसलिए हम चाहते हैं कि अब जो भी कोई सरकार आए, जो भी आए, कम से कम काम करे. हमें पार्टी देख के वोट नहीं देना, हमें देखना है कि जो काम करेगा वही, उसी को जिताना है हमें आगे के लिए, वही यही होगा.
तो आप ये कहना चाहते हैं आपका सिटिंग काउंसलर जो यहाँ पे थे, उन्होंने आपके लिए कुछ काम नहीं किया?
जो सिटिंग काउंसलर थे उन्होंने वाकई में कोई काम नहीं किया. आप जितनी भी इंक्रोचमेंट लाल क्वार्टर तक जाए, फुटपाथ तो है नहीं, खुद उतनी शॉप है और आगे से किराया ले रहे हैं, तो ये बहुत दिक्कत वाली बात है. और इसके अलावा अब जो उनसे हमारे बग्गा जी ने जरूर काम कराया है यहाँ पे, जिस रोड पे हम यहाँ खड़े हैं, 20 साल बाद ये रोड बनी है. लेकिन हम चाहते हैं जैसे एमएलए काम करते रहे वैसे यहाँ का नया जो काउंसिल रहेगा वो भी काम करे।
प्रॉब्लम्स बहुत हैं, वी कैन लोगों में नेगेटिविटी बहुत है, लोग यही सोच के बैठ जाते हैं कि अब कुछ काम नहीं होना है, क्योंकि वो भी नहीं आते हैं और लोग भी नहीं जाते हैं। एटलीस्ट वो आएँ, हमारी प्रॉब्लम्स सुनें और उनको एक एक करके हम सॉर्ट आउट कर सकते हैं। वी आर हेयर टू कॉपरेट एंड वी कैन डू इफ वी आर यूनाइट। सो दिस इज माई एक्सपेक्टेशन फ्रॉम न्यू काउंसलर।
जो भी आए वो गंदगी, ये सबसे ज़्यादा है इशू की गंदगी सारे जगह। जब हमारे यहाँ सरकार बनती है तो ये कहा जाता है कि गंदगी हटाएंगे, लेकिन गंदगी हटी नहीं है, गंदगी और बढ़ती चली जा रही है। कचरेदान में कचरा पड़ा रहता है, कसरता रहता है, बीमारियाँ फैलती रहती हैं। आए दिन यही इशू रहता है कि गर्मियाँ शुरू हुई नहीं, बीमारियाँ शुरू हो गई।
अलॉन्ग विद सैनिटेशन ऑल द मेंबर्स ऑफ द RWA एक्चुअली नीड इज टू फॉर द काउंसिलर्स और द सिटिंग काउंसिलर्स टू कम एंड विजिट देम। समथिंग लाइक अ मीटिंग शुड बी हेल्ड एटलीस्ट वंस अ मंथ टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड सो दैट देर इज अकाउंटेबिलिटी फ्रॉम द काउंसिलर्स टुवर्ड्स द RWA। इन न्यू दिल्ली दिस इज मिलन शर्मा फॉर मेरा नाउ।
Maharashtra Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis inaugurated the ambitious scheme on Saturday to revamp one of the oldest chawls in central Mumbai. Under the plan, the state expects to build at least 16,000 affordable houses in the space-starved city. Now, the groundbreaking ceremony for the project, which was delayed by 21 years to redevelop the British-era Bombay Development Department or BDD chawls, was finally held at Worli's Jambori Maidan. Meanwhile, 12 people who protested against the ambitious scheme were taken into custody. Amita, who was on ground earlier today, sent us his report.
Despite facing severe opposition from residents, tenants here BDD chawls, especially Worli, CM Devendra Fadnavis has gone ahead and inaugurated BDD chawl redevelopment. In fact, I have a couple of residents with me. Let's find out what their problems are. Pehle ye aap bataiye sir, aapki main demands kya hai, aap kyun oppose kar rahe
ho? हमारी बीडी चल के रीडेवलपमेंट के लिए अपोज नहीं है, जिस तरह से रीडेवलपमेंट हो रही है उसके लिए अपोज है, क्योंकि ये 500 बोल रहे हैं। कारपेट है, बिल्ड है, आज तक किसी ने हमें लिख के नहीं दिया, महाड़ा ने तो ऑफिशियल लिख के नहीं दिया है।
आप कितने साल से रह रहे हो यहाँ पे, और ये भी बताइए कि गवर्नमेंट ने आपके साथ कुछ मीटिंग किया था इसके पहले?
अभी हम लोग यहाँ पे कम से कम 35-40 साल से इधर रह रहे हैं, पर गवर्नमेंट ने एक्चुअली जो प्रोसीजर है उस हिसाब से स्थानिक लोग को विश्वास में लेना चाहिए। डेवलपमेंट का जो प्रोजेक्ट वो लोग ला रहे हैं, अमल बजावनी कर रहे हैं, जिस तरह स्थानिक को बताना चाहिए कि एग्जैक्ट 500 का घर कहाँ पे होगा, किस तरीके से होगा, ये कुछ ही तरीके से हम लोग को बता रहे नहीं है। क्या चल रहा है लोग का खुद में ही मालूम है, और स्थानिक लोग को विश्वास भी लोग ने लिया ही नहीं है।
आप ये भी बताइए कि अभी गवर्नमेंट ने आपको बोला है कि कौन कौन एलिजिबल होगा, कितना स्क्वायर फीट मिलेगा, आपको कुछ क्लैरिटी है?
गवर्नमेंट ने हमको सिर्फ ओरली बोला है, हम ओरली नहीं चलेंगे। एक्चुअली हमको उन्होंने बाय राइडिंग में देना चाहिए कि आपको ये 500 का एरिया जो फैसिलिटी ये और कौन डेवलप कर रहा है, वो भी आपने उन्होंने डिक्लेयर नहीं किया। और भूमि पूजन कभी किया जाता है, ये सब पूरे सबको एजे मीटिंग के बाद एक अपना मंजूर होता है कि बाबा आपको ये दिया जाएगा, लेकिन उन्होंने कुछ ऐसा किया नहीं और डायरेक्ट अपना मनमानी करके वहाँ पे भूमि पूजन कर दिया।
तो आप ये बताइए अभी आगे जाके क्या होगा, अगर वर्ली का टेंडर अभी तक निकला नहीं है, 2 महीने होगा, आगे जाके क्या होगा, आप क्या करने वाले हो?
हमें विरोध नहीं है डेवलपमेंट का, उल्टा हम स्वागत करते हैं इस डिसीजन का, बट हमें भी कुछ बताया जाए, हमें विश्वास में लिया जाए। हम यहाँ हमारे 3-3 पीढ़ियां यहाँ पे रहती हैं, हम भी चाहते हैं डेवलपमेंट। आज हम जो सदियों से हमारा रखड़ा हुआ डेवलपमेंट है आज इस सरकार ने पूरा किया, हमें स्वागत है, अच्छा है हमें, बट हमें विश्वास भी लिया जाए, ये लोकशाही है, हुकुमशाही नहीं है।
So basically there you see that residents are extremely unhappy with the fact that the government has not told them a couple of things, not given them clarity about what exactly is happening on ground. Amita Balachandra from Mirror Now.
Time now for a short break, but after the break, Food and of Consumer Affairs Minister Ram Vilas Paswan has said that the service charge that you pay on hotel bills is totally voluntary. More details on the other side. Stay with us. Welcome back. You're with the news on Mirror Now. In Chennai, doctors' protest has intensified. Now, outpatient services and elective services stayed shut on Saturday as more doctors went on leave. Doctors also extended what was initially a one-day protest against the High Court's decision to scrap the quota in postgraduate seats for doctors on rural posting. Shweta gets us more.
Doctors are continuing their strike in Chennai today. They want 50% of the state quota to be retained. If otherwise, they said that they would be continuing with their strike. Outpatient services and the elective services have been suspended so far, due to which a large number of patients are finding it difficult to get their treatments done. The doctors here told us that the state quota system should be retained. If otherwise, they said the people in living in the rural areas would be affected, and also it would take a huge toll on the health industry. Madras High Court's hearing is coming up on Monday, and they're hoping for a favorable outcome. If that is not happening, they said that the protests would get intensified. Ultimately, those who are affected are only the patients. In Chennai, Shweta for Mirano.
The doctors சில இடத்துல ரொம்ப கம்மியாக இருக்குது, சில இடத்துல இல்லவே இல்லை. இதனால் மக்களுக்கு ரொம்ப கஷ்டமாக இருக்குது. நாங்கள் உள்ளே இருக்கிறதுனால எங்களுக்கு கொஞ்சம் பரவாயில்லை. அவுட்லேருந்து வரவங்களுக்கு ரொம்ப டாக்டர் இல்லாமல் ரொம்ப கஷ்டமாக தான் இருக்குது. சீக்கிரமாக முடிஞ்சால் கொஞ்சம் நல்லாயிருக்கும்.
திஸ் இன்சிடென்ட் ஐ திங்க் திஸ் இஸ் ஹேட் பீன் ஹேப்பனிங் ஃபார் லாஸ்ட் த்ரூ டூ த்ரீ டேஸ் இஸ் ஹேப்பனிங் இயர். ஸோ லுக்கிங் ஆஃப்டர் தட் மெனி பேஷன்ஸ் ஆர் மோர் பேஷன்ஸ் ஆர் கம்மிங் இயர் பிகாஸ் த கவர்மெண்ட் ஸ்கீம். ஸோ மெனி பீப்புள்ஸ் ஆர் கம்மிங் இயர் ஃபார் லெஸர் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட்ஸ். So due to that, many people are suffering because doctors have been protesting against for their tuition.
In Chennai Medical College, in front of the Chennai, on behalf of the Chennai district, we are going to protest, impress the government to give the ordinance, special ordinance for protecting the 50% quota. And we are going to conduct a human chain in front of the Madras Medical College. And Monday, in throughout Tamil Nadu, we are going, government doctors are going to put mass casual leave, and we all assemble in the district headquarters and show our agitation, and we request the government to implement in proper way to get the order in favor of us and to save the existing rights of the Tamil Nadu Government Doctors Association.
This judgment, this High Court judgment, is a mockery of the entire public healthcare system of Tamil Nadu, which is one of the best healthcare systems in this country. Thousands of young doctors join the public healthcare system, the government service, just for one purpose, serving the people, and with the hope that they will get a postgraduate seat in the near future. We are protesting in a very peaceful manner. We have just boycotted elective surgeries, outpatient department. All the emergency surgeries and essential services are going on as planned.
The new undergraduates, we have to give our house surgeon period, which is our which is part of our course. For it'll extend, and even specialty doctors who have completed their PG, they have to come to the rural level. So when there are no basic doctors to give health care, those who have already studied and are professors, we cannot take care of the tertiary health centers. Everyone would have to come to the primary.
Time now to take a look at what is making news across the nation. To deal with the current water crisis that Tamil Nadu is facing, the minister Sellu Raju put thermocol sheets worth rupees 10 lakh on the water near Vaigai Dam in Madurai. The sheets supposedly will prevent water from evaporating. This happened while Tamil Nadu farmers continue to protest in the national capital. And in probably what was his worst nightmare, a groom from Madhya Pradesh's Neemuch district allegedly accidentally killed a 10-year-old boy from the bride's side while performing a ritual with his sword at his wedding. The ceremony was called off as the bride's family refused to go ahead with the marriage after the incident.
ये काफी दुखद घटना घटी है. उनकी जो एक सामाजिक परंपरा है, तो शादी के दौरान दूल्हा जो है वो पेड़ पर तलवार से वार करता है, और तलवार से वार करते समय उसके बगल में उन्हीं की फैमिली का एक बच्चा था, जिससे बच्चे को चोट लग गई और पुलिस द्वारा तत्काल उसे नीमच लाया गया, लेकिन बच्चे की असामयिक मृत्यु हो गई. और इस आधार पर पुलिस ने, चूंकि घटना काफ़ी गंभीर थी, पुलिस ने अपराध कायम किया है और फूलचंद दूल्हे को गिरफ्तार कर लिया गया है.
Six people, including a 9-year-old girl, were injured after cow vigilantes allegedly attacked them in Riyasi in the Jammu area. The victims say that the attackers took away their entire flock, including goats, sheep and cows. No arrests have been made so far. And four children got locked in a broken down car while playing near their house in UP's Amroha district. Allegedly, the children climbed into the broken down car and closed the door, which activated the car's central locking system. Trapped within, the two children died of suffocation, while the other two continued to beat on the car window and were rescued by a passerby.
दूसरे वालों ने पकौड़ी वालों ने बताए थे नो तुम्हारे बच्चे हूँ उस गाड़ी में खत्म हो गई तो मैं भाग कर गई थी तो फिर जो आ गया था तो कि मम्मी खत्म हो गई लल्ली तो फिर मैं भाग कर यहाँ को ले आई थी बस
तो क्या खेल रही थी गाड़ी में क्या करने गई थी
गाड़ी में बंद हो गए तो जो खोला था उन्होंने खेलने गए थे पहले तो यहाँ से बुलाया मैंने पिलखंतरा से बुला लिए दोनों बालक फिर ना पता चली
The Indian drug regulator has declared popular medicines like Combiflam and D-Cold as substandard after a series of quality tests conducted last month. Now, these are pills that we don't think twice before popping and is sold and manufactured by big names in the industry like Sanofi India, Reckitt Benckiser, Cipla and Cadila. Adrija Chatterjee gets more details.
The Central Indian Drug Regulator has come down heavily on certain medicines that is extremely popular, medicines which we do not think twice before popping. Some of the names here are D-Cold Total, Combiflam, even Theoacetylene and Cadila Solution. These are medicines that we have come across frequently, extremely popular medicines which have been declared as substandard by the drug regulator. As a matter of fact, Combiflam back in 2015 had also received several warnings for being substandard, as a result of which the company had to call back several batches. This is an important step taken by the drug regulator after they decided to overhaul the entire process of regulating the Indian drug market. In fact, there are some huge names here involved, including Cipla, Reckitt Benckiser and Sanofi India. So what we need to see next is that when do they get the official notice from the central drug regulator and what kind of investigation will go into order to ensure that such medicine, such substandard medicine do not reach the market again and again. And these companies have to definitely call back these batches, these affected batches again. And what next step will be taken by the regulator to ensure that there is no such repeat offense in this case.
And that's a wrap on this edition of the news. For more news and updates, do stay tuned to Mirror Now.